recognize and celebrate both the investors and the companies who really came together in a true partnership-like fashion to build these businesses.
Absolutely. With so many great companies being nominated, it was definitely a tough task to select the winners. But before we begin, I'd like to call on stage Sahad PV, editor and publisher, VC Circle, to tell us more about the awards.
Hi, good evening. It's an honor to have your presence for the third edition of VC Circle Awards. This is the only award in India that recognizes the best performance among private equity and venture capital funded companies. Thank you all very much for being here today, this evening. When we started this award 2 years ago, the idea was to find and select the best performing entrepreneurial companies, not only financially, but also in many ways, such as innovations, industry disruption, market leadership, corporate governance, and the quality of business, and also those who are presenting high growth in their own industries. Private equity and venture capital is about 2 decades old now. The major flow of PVC money started in 1999. That was the first dot-com rush. Essentially, the first phase of PE money started flowing in the form of venture capital, early stage venture capital. By early 2000, we started seeing PE capital getting deployed in relatively mature companies at growth stage and also in listed companies in the pipe mode. So from then, PEVC was getting more mainstream and several entrepreneurs could build their businesses with the help of private equity. As of today, there are over 3,000 companies that have got PEVC funding. That's a huge number considering the listed company universe is only 5,000. So about $60 to $80 billion have come in the form of private equity into India. And that's not a small sum. So PEVC has really unleashed entrepreneurship in India. I can see a lot of companies today nominated who've been able to really build their companies only because the PEVC money has flowed into those companies. So as a premium publication in India, which has been at the forefront of covering entrepreneurship, venture capital and private equity, and the people behind these activities, we decided to award those PEVC funded companies across various industries and for their performance across various parameters like financial growth, quality of business, governance, and so on. So this is the third year of VC Circle Awards. And I would like to thank all of you for being here. This really means a lot to us. And I would like to thank the members of the jury, especially the jury chairman, Mr. V.K. Bansal, who's the chairman of Morgan Stanley Investment Banking, and Mr. Motilal Oswal's Ramdev Agarwal, and Sanjeev Bikchandani of Naukri.com, Rajiv Luthra of Luthra and Luthra. So distinguished jury has really spent a lot of time. We had several calls, several meetings to deliberate on the nominations and finally pick the winners. They really took a lot of pain in understanding these companies, their models, their financials, and really make a very informed choice on their winning picks. Moreover, the jury has really put the head on these winners, so I'm sure it's a very well thought out decision in picking these winners. I'm sure all of you are eagerly waiting to hear who are the winners. So once again, a very hearty welcome to all the members of the audience and distinguished guests. Thank you, and over to you, Srijayanan.
Thank you, sir. We now begin with the awards.
But I think just before we begin, I think it's a good idea to have the jury talk about the selection process themselves. Can we have the jury video, please?
VC Circle provided the jury with the collated data on PE-backed or the VC-backed and the advisors with specific information on growth, innovation, and impact on each company. The jury members followed a very judicious process to rate the shortlisted companies under each category.
So the process was pretty deliberative. The jury actually first got together to decide what the selection process was going to be. And once we chose the right process, the jury members went back and thought about each of the different categories.
And they had quite a scientific way of sort of figuring out who should win and who should not. There was an objective criteria, which basically talked about scalability, about EBITDA, about all of those kinds of things. And it talked about return on investment, etc.
The jury members also viewed qualitative criteria like innovation, quality of management, corporate governance standards, uniqueness of business, and potential to grow the business.
And then based on that, came up with the selections. There was, each of the jury members gave their choices in terms of who the winners were for each of the categories. And then we came together again just to deliberate what the differences might be. And at the end of the day, I feel like we came back with a very good set of winners. Obviously, in many instances, it was a close call. But as we talked through the distinctive features of each of the candidates, we came to a consensus in terms of who the winners were for each of the categories. So overall, I thought a good deliberative process that was employed.
The investment banks and the law firms were evaluated on the basis of number of deals, value of deals, and the innovation in deal structuring.
The companies that were brought on the table, I know quite a few of those companies, or at least know of them, and they seem to be of very high quality.
The quality of companies, for the most part, was good.
And we found VC Circle to be very scientific in shortlisting the companies under each category. And our experience of dealing with VC Circle was very professional.
Indeed, there were many good nominees who were neck to neck with each other on various parameters. And the best part about VC Circle Awards is that while there is only one winner in each category, there are no losers. That is because each of the nominees are a cut above the rest.
Absolutely, which is why starting this year, VC Circle will present all the nominees with a token of appreciation too.
With that thought, we now move ahead to the first category of the night. You know what, Shrija, with underdog Aam Aadmi Party, or as we call it AAP, sweeping the Delhi elections, I'm actually planning to start an information technology company of my own. I've actually even thought of a name for the same.
And what will that be?
Well, I'm actually going to call it propaganda, patented after a lot of propaganda, or as I like to call it, PAP. Based out of Bangalore, the Silicon Valley of India, we will basically focus on stealing other companies' patents, and we'll actually make a propaganda whenever we get caught.
Well, good luck with that, Anand. I think someone like you can really pull that off. But the fact remains that Indian IT companies do need to break with the past and ride on the cloud, social media, big data, and mobility to power growth. A lot of times they have been accused of being happy just milking the software service cow and not focusing on disrupting the market or reinventing the wheel. This brings us to our first category, the PEVC-backed Information Technology Company of the Year.
iGate Corp provides IT and IT-enabled outsourcing services to financial services, insurance, manufacturing, media, and healthcare sectors. Its services include server design and development, migration services, offshore outsourcing, and ERP package implementation. Bangalore-based Visory Interactive Solutions, which was founded in 2008, is a digital marketing firm. It provides services in the areas of consumer electronics, automobiles, hospitality, IT and ITES, consultancy and education. Capillary Technologies is a technology solutions company. It offers mobile-based customer management solutions for apparel retailers. The company was founded in 2008 and is based in Bangalore, Karnataka. Quicksilver Solutions offers gift card programs, loyalty programs, discount programs, mall card for retailers, service providers, and convenience and operational efficiency program for corporates like campus cards, incentives, and benefit cards.
Can I please call on stage Mr. Leo Puri to do the honors, come upon the stage and announce the name of the winner.
The winner for the category, the PVC-backed IT Company of the Year, goes to iGate Corporation.
Highgate Corporation has been rated the best company under the information technology category. Apex Capital helped Highgate to complete the buyout of Putney Computers and thereby leading IT services company with revenue exceeding US$1 billion. Post-acquisition, margins have increased substantially as a result of operational improvements and acquisition of best of the talents from the industry. Therefore, we found Highgate is the right company to be awarded as the best company.
Hey, good evening to all of you. And many thanks to VC Circle and the Honorable Jury for recognizing Highgate and thinking that we are fit to win this. I think the reason for winning this and for the success of Highgate is, as Mr. Puri rightly said, the right alignment, understanding and trust between the investors and the management.
And this sort of brings us to our next award category, the PEVC-backed Consumer Internet Company of the Year.
The winner for the PEVC-backed Consumer Internet Company of the Year goes to Myntra Design Private Limited.
First of all, I would like to thank VC Circle for choosing us for this award. I strongly believe the consumer internet space is just heating up. It's just a beginning. And after receiving this award, I feel like, okay, there are many more awards that probably we have to achieve. This space is definitely going to become probably 10 to 20 times in coming years. So that's what I feel.
Today, a number of companies are providing specialized e-learning programs, virtual classrooms, self-study content, and next-generation interactive learning systems that are designed to change the way a student learns. This has completely changed the way we look at education for the PEVC-backed education company.
Good evening, friends. This prestigious award goes to Manipal Global Education Services.
Good evening, everyone, and thanks to VC Circle. So I was just thinking that while we have done reasonably well as a company, to be told by an investor, even if he was a Swedish marriage, is what Mr. Puri, you put it, to be told that we have done very well and they have recommended us for this award. While there were 4 PE investors with us, we have Apurva Patel from IDFC PE. Thanks, Apurva, for putting us up. And thanks very much. It's indeed an honor and pleasure to be here.
Moving ahead to our next category, and that is for the PEVC-backed Financial Services Company of the Year.
The PEVC-backed Financial Services Company of the Year goes to Repco Home Finance Limited.
Well, first I would like to thank VC Circle for recognizing what the company has done in the converting the dreams of many of the people to own their own house. Thank you very much, VC Circle, for that. And I'd like to thank all those people who are involved in nominating this company for this award. The next, I'd like to thank the jury for having gone through a voluminous amount of papers and then recognizing what this company has done. I'd like to thank the jury for this.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Congratulations.
Let's to our next category, and that is for the PEVC-backed Healthcare Company for the Year.
And the winner is Cloudin Hospital's Kids Clinic.
I feel I'm on cloud nine now. But we couldn't have started this company without the team, which our family and friends we started with. So I sincerely thank my wife Vidya, who was behind the concept, and Ashok Kumar, my co-brother, Rohit, my nephew, and Ramchandra, who are the co-founders. Once we started showing the success, we were looking for a lover, not a wife, Mr. Puri. And the first lover we found was Matrix Partners, who believed in our dreams. And since then, our love affair is continuing. And then we found Sequoia Partners.
And we have the nominations for the PEVC-backed Media and Communications Company of the Year.
The winner of the PEVC-backed Media and Communications Company of the Year goes to PVR Limited.
It's a wonderful acknowledgement, massive appreciation for what we've been doing in the entertainment space. So thank you, VC Circle, thank you, jury members. And we accept this respectfully and most humbly on behalf of everyone at PVR and also at Cinemax, which is now part of PVR. Thank you.
Moving ahead to our next category, which is the PEVC-backed manufacturing company.
And the winner in this category for manufacturing is International Tractors.
Thank you, VC Circle. It's a great honor and a pleasure to be with you amongst you. And my special thanks to JM Finance, who proposed this honor for us. Thank you very much.
Our next category for the night is the PEVC-backed Consumer Company of the Year.
And the winner for the Consumer Company of the Year is And Designs Private Limited.
Thank you, everybody who thought us fit for this honor. We don't really work for awards, but it's good to be recognized, and it's all about team efforts in our company. So thank you.
The next award is for the PEVC-backed Infrastructure Company of the Year.
Winner of the PEVC-backed Infrastructure Company of the Year goes to GMR Airports.
Well, my name is Siddharth Kapoor. I'm the President and CFO for GMR Airports. On behalf of our Group Chairman, Mr. GM Rao, and our Group Holding Board, it's an honor to be here and receive this award. Thank you, Uday Stancy, for nominating us. Thank you, VC Circle, for considering our nomination. And thank you, the jury, for choosing us as the winner in this category. As I said, it's a great honor for us to be here and receive this award. It means a lot to us, because definitely GMR Group represents entrepreneurship, it represents governance, and it represents value delivery to the shareholders and stakeholders which are part of the group.
We have the nominations for the Investment Bank of the Year in the Bulge Bracket category.
Good evening, friends. Very prestigious award, Investment Bank of the Year Private Equity Bulge Bracket goes to
Credit Suisse Securities India Private Limited.
Hi, I think at the start we'd like to thank VC Circle, the eminent jury. It's always great to get it from competition, an award, but we'd like to thank the eminent jury to go through this. And finally, you know, we'd like to thank our clients who sort of stood through us and reposed their trust in us to go ahead and sort of give us their deals, which are very important exits, as Mr. Puri has said, through their sort of life cycle of a deal.
The Investment Bank of the Year in the mid-market category.
The winner in this category is Avendus Capital.
Thank you. Thank you so much. You know, all I'd like to say is we finally found somebody who appreciates the work that we do. So thank you so much to VC Circle and a very distinguished jury. There's some, phenomenal people on the jury, and it's really an honor to get this award for them. So thank you so much, and we'll accept this on behalf of the investment banking community, because we collectively have found people who appreciate our work.
This brings us to our next category, which is for the PEVC Pact Law Firm of the Year.
The winner of the Law Firm of the Year Private Equity goes to Khaitan & Company.
Well, thank you very much, VC Circle and the jury members. Congratulations to the other nominees. I accept this on behalf of the entire firm, the partners, lawyers, and the entire staff, without whom it's never possible. Thank you.
We wrap up this evening. Can we please have all the winners, along with the jury, our chief guest, and of course, my boss and VCircle's founder, Sahad PV, to congregate on the stage for the group photograph.